today we'll be making the T-bar snare. I've already went ahead and collected all the material needed. I just went and cut two branches, little hooks on the ends. Now what I like to do, I mean every trapper is different or what have you, but I like to take and have enough so as it goes to your finger to your elbow. That way, there's a less chance of it pulling it out of the ground. Whereas this one, I've went ahead and cut it shorter, about 2 inches shorter. Hope that it doesn't come out of the ground, but the chances it will. But you can see how much shorter it is. It's about 3 fingers shorter than the long one. And all, you know, you got your bar that goes over, goes underneath the both of them, your bait stick, and your budding stick. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put this in the ground and show you what it looks like set up, and then we'll pull the snare over, the branch over, and set it up on film as well. So stay tuned. See that there or not? That's all it is, just two sticks there. It opening like that. This here is my bait stick or my budding stick. Now all I'm gonna do is put it on here. You want to put it right in the middle. Your bait stick, you want to put it in this underneath, but have it in the center, because that's where your toggle snare is going to be at. You don't want to put it on the outside because then you'll be too close. So put it underneath the dead center. And place your bait stick right here. And just shove it in the ground. Okay. Now, as for your snare, what you want, or what I do rather, I go from my hand, I just pinch it, and I have it long so it can go from my fingertip to the center of my body. And then that's where I would tie a little snare or knot, basically is all it is. You ain't got to cut no grooves around it. It's just a little stick. You stick in there, cinch it up. Now this, the small tag end, that's where your snare is going to be. And then this excess, that's what's going to be tied to the tree. So let's go ahead and bring the sapling over. That right there is where we want to be. I'm just going to go ahead and wrap this around. It'll be no big deal or nothing, no big. Just getting it out of the way. And a little tip, if you want to have it so as you can use both hands, which I'm about to show you what that is. You want to use both hands, you just go out here on your tag end, wrap it around your foot, get over here so we can position it. Just wrap it around your foot a couple of times. And there you can use both hands. This is a little tidbit if you're wanting to set something, you know, something fell out or something of that nature. But we're about ready to have the trap set. So what we're going to do is pull that bar up underneath that and wrap it over the front. Okay, now keep some pressure on that. It doesn't fly up. Now as your bait stick, it's going to go here on the on your toggle. Bring it under. Now prior to doing this, you would want to take some peanut butter. You can get the Jiffy brand or whatever, it doesn't matter, want some little nuts in it or whatever. You just want to put some on your fingers and very sparingly put it along the rod, put it up here at the front of the rod. And then just place it on your toggle switch and place it so as it's really, really sensitive. Okay, now it's set. All I have to do now is to make my snare. So what I'm going to do here is going to make a bite in a rope, fold it down over on itself, and make it real small. So you have something like that. Now, all I'm going to do is pull the excess rope through it. Now where your knot's at, or you want it up front as well. You want it right there at the very tip. Spread this out. That way, good and set. Find something to set this off with. When they come to investigate the trap, you know, the curious smells or what have you, when they set this off, when they just barely touch this, it catches. Okay? Thanks for watching.